Okay, so you've watched all my videos. You were completely prepared for the transition to senior housing. No stress, no anxiety, everything perfect, thanks to me. Well, you're welcome, but it hasn't ended yet. Because once your loved one's in the facility, I'm going to give you two ways to evaluate whether they're getting good care or not, whether you did choose the right place. This is a very simple formula that I've used for 17 years in senior housing. It's how I've always known if I had overall good operations or not. And that is happy and safe. Is your loved one happy and are they safe? If those two things are in place, then everything else is kind of small stuff. And in senior housing, it is true. If you sweat the small stuff, you'll never stop sweating. For instance, say you see that the bed isn't made to the standard that you want, and maybe there's some things on the floor and the drawers are a mess and not folded clothes, things like that. It's important to bring that up and ask if it can be done. It's also important for the facility to lay out expectations and boundaries with you. Maybe your loved one likes to go into the room and fiddle through all the clothing numerous times a day, and that's fun for them. The facility's not going to stop that, and they're also not going to refold every single bit of clothing and put it back perfectly every time, because it has nothing to do with their safety. They're safe doing that. The facility does need to make sure that it's not a fall risk, that there aren't things on the floor that could create a fall or something like that. But in terms of those drawers, that resident, that is not a priority, and it shouldn't be a priority for you. The next resident in the next room over may have perfectly folded clothes in their drawer and they don't ever mess with it, and it's just fine. I use that example because it's come up a lot throughout my years in senior housing. And once I explain to families why this is, then usually they understand. The other thing is caregivers hear about all the bad stuff and hear very little thank yous. And that's a really big problem in senior housing. Caregivers are extremely underappreciated. With all the caregiver month and caregiver day, and every building does different caregiver appreciation, that's not enough. Caregivers need to hear from you. They need to hear that you appreciate what they do, even when things aren't going right. Being a caregiver is like getting a haircut. If you get a great haircut, you don't tell anyone about it, and you go about your day, and some people say, I like your haircut, and you say, thank you. If you get a bad haircut, you tell everyone, I'm really upset with how they did my hair, and you tell them their name, their address, their phone number, email, where to go on Yelp to give them a bad review. And that's what it's like as a caregiver. They can literally do hundreds of things right and not hear about it sometimes. And then they do one thing wrong and they hear about it from every angle. It's a very tough job. So if you are that type of family that's sweating the small stuff, then you're not doing anything toward getting your loved one the best care possible. You're not contributing toward that. You're not helping. So stop sweating the small stuff. Look at what's important. Is your loved one happy and are they safe? If you have those two things, you have everything. I want to thank you for watching my video. My name's Jeff Kaufman. I've been in senior housing since 2004. I've been a licensed administrator in 4 states and I own my own assisted living for 10 years. So I've been around the block. I'm taking my experiences to share with you because I really want to help you have a better experience. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel. I upload videos on a regular basis. And also, please go hit that like button on the video. That helps YouTube know you like it and they share it with others so that they get this valuable information. See you next time, everyone.